Before we do that, I wanted to say a few words about VBS. And I actually really struggled knowing, like, okay, how do I talk about VBS in a succinct way? And you might be thinking, Evan, how do you talk about anything in a succinct way? We haven't found that, you know, groove for you yet. But VBS in particular, there's just so much about it. There's so much dynamic. There's so much depth. There's so much activity. I struggled in thinking about how to even talk about it in just a couple of minutes. But the Lord reminded me of a scripture that we have been going over as a church. And I want to bring you there. So open up your Bibles, if you would, to Jeremiah chapter 6. Jeremiah chapter 6. I've mentioned a couple of times that I'm reading through Exodus, Leviticus, and now I'm in Numbers, and I'm spending a lot of time in those books. And I got to tell you, there has been no more dynamic time in me reading those books than this time through for myself. Things that used to confuse me, things that were super dry, like building the tabernacle. You guys, I got something out of the priestly garments, okay? Only the Holy Spirit of God could do that, describing, like, you know, and these are the outfits that the priests wear, and I'm like, God, you're so good. The revelation is overwhelming. It's been so dynamic, and something I've noticed this time through is that God repeats himself quite a few times, and that was actually something that confused me, because there isn't just, like, one section where he talks about the Sabbath. There isn't just one section when he talks about worship or offerings. It's, like, all throughout there. But this is what the Lord revealed to me, what he showed me, is that Israel at that time was, by comparison, an extremely uninstructed people. That if you think about the time before God gave the law, there really weren't that many commandments or instructions on how to live that God had given, ever. And then Israel came out of Egypt, they came out of a really hard time, and they're going through the wilderness, and then God downloaded them onto them so much information about his heart, the future, the way that he wanted us to live, who he was, who we are, so much stuff. And so he repeated himself often so that people who hadn't heard these things before, who were trying to live in a new way, would remember them. And in fact, it says there a lot in those scriptures, so that you wouldn't forget. So that's my long and biblical way of saying, I'm going to repeat some things to you right now, which is a hard thing for me to do because I don't like to repeat myself because I'm so like, let's go to the future. Why would we go backwards when we can go that way? So it's hard for me to kind of reiterate some things that we have talked about as a church, but I realized, do you know what? God is bringing us into a very fresh season where we are doing things that we hadn't done before or haven't done in a long time. And so some repetition will help these things really sink into our souls and not just be things like, okay, yeah, I know that, let's keep going. So Jeremiah chapter 6, this is kind of like, I call it a hinge verse. What I mean by that is, I picture in my mind sometimes like a gate opening, and the way that the gate opens is because it's connected to the wall by these hinges. And so understanding direction was open to us because of this very simple scripture. It says this, thus says the Lord, stand by the ways and see and ask for the ancient paths where the good way is and walk in it, and you shall find rest for your souls. Jeremiah 6:16. Did I not say the verse? 6, everyone's like, come on, Nick, come on, let's go. 6:16, Jeremiah 6:16. I'll read it again. I'll repeat myself again. Here we go. Stand by the ways and see and ask for the ancient paths where the good way is and walk in it, and you shall find rest for your souls. When it says ways there, it basically means like a street. So the instruction here is go to where there is a huge intersection of a bunch of streets, see them, wait there, and then ask the Lord, which one of these streets is this ancient path, is this good way that you are wanting me to walk in? And then, once he tells you, walk in it. And as you do that, you will find rest for your souls. God has been establishing, reminding us of ancient paths of our church. Things that we get to do that we have done long ago. And for some of you, like I said, it might be completely new. But for our church, it's really not. And VBS is one of these incredible intersection points. like Grand Central Station, where there are so many tracks that are intersecting at VBS. And you're going to hear about some of these streets, some of these ways of living, ways of thinking, ways of participating and contributing that Michael's going to bring before you. And what I want to reiterate to you is that the Lord is inviting us to ask him, what is the path that you want me to walk in? And it might feel or seem ancient to you, or like been there, done that. And that might even be the answer for you. If that's how you feel, that might be the way that God wants you to walk in, because he's wanting us to walk in ancient paths. But as you listen to Michael and as you hear about VBS, what we are doing, what the heart is for VBS, I want you to do this thing. You see all these streets. Ask the Lord while he's talking, which one or more of these streets that are being described to me is the way, God, that you want me to walk in? And the promise is that as you walk in that, you will find rest. This is something that defies natural logic, because what I'm saying is we're about to do this huge thing as a church, and it's going to require a lot of us, a lot more from us than is kind of otherwise the case for a normal week. And as we do more, God's promise is we will find rest. That doesn't make any sense. Anybody else? Doesn't make any sense. Do more and you'll be more rested. That doesn't make any sense in the natural. So what I want to ask you to do is to even just right now prepare your heart and ask the Lord, okay, God, I want to have ears to hear and eyes to see as you see things in the spiritual realm, the significance of these things. And then hear what the Lord has to say for you this evening. VBS is such a wonderful time because to me, it's like this microcosm, or it's like orange juice concentrate. There's so much packed into this thing that is true about the kingdom of God. And even for somebody who just has an hour to offer, gets a taste of this thing, and because it's so concentrated, it gives them so much life. And even more so for people who are able to contribute even more and be a part of the entire week, you will receive so much as you give yourself to this. And I just want to contextualize what this means for our church, because the heart of what I want, what I believe the Lord wants for our church to do, is so well captured by VBS. We are a body of Christ, and each of us gets the opportunity to contribute different things to this thing we call VBS. But that is such a beautiful picture of what it means to be the body, because maybe you're not an on-stage person. Maybe you're not somebody who can take a week off of work to be a team leader. But all of us together contributing towards this thing, and we become a more complete picture of Jesus Christ to kids. That's what we're talking about here. We're talking about kids whose eternities will be changed based upon a simple decision that we all make, to say, I will take steps down this ancient path, Lord. Yes, I'll say yes. And lives are changed. To me, VBS represents like the heartbeat of our church, that the accomplishment of many in the Spirit of God goes way beyond what we could dream or imagine for. And what a beautiful thing, as we are experiencing the healing and the rebuilding of our body of Jesus, our local expression of the body of Christ, that one of the first things that God is asking us to do is to work on our heart. So as you listen to Michael, your heart is going to beat. As you watch the video that we have prepared for you, your heart is going to beat. And I implore you, pay attention to your heart. The Bible says in Proverbs, guard your heart with all diligence, because God designed it that life flows out of your heart. And you could be someone that has life flowing out of your heart to these kids, to others, during VBS. Let your heart be spoken to this evening. You hear me? Yeah. Okay. I know we're all excited, but this is a really significant moment for me because of how incredible VBS is and because of what I believe will be true of the changing lives of people who come to VBS. So I can't wait. So without further ado, can we run the video?
Let it be our own fire.
Oh man, that was so great. I love seeing all those little faces and the big faces too, you know, but you know, the kids are the ones that really get me. Seeing them all up there on that stage is just so amazing. But VBS is a blast, you guys. And I just want to say one last thing before I bring Michael up, that God's not small, you know? I mean, he's huge. And how does my hair look? Because I spent a lot of time on it. God's not small, he's huge, you know what I mean? For those of you who don't know, I played a VBS character for 10 years, believe it or not. 10 years of my life, that's a third of my life. I played a VBS character. It was such a blast. It was such a blast, so much fun. So Michael Martinez, I wanna invite you up. Would you cheer him on as he comes up? Welcome him. Tell us how we can have a blast, Michael.
Yeah! Woo! Well, that was really fun already. That was awesome. I really do have a lot to say, and I'm going to pack it in this time that we have together. Amen and amen and amen. Thank you, Evan, for that introduction. Not my introduction, but the VBS introduction, because it's so important to understand the groundwork of why we get to do what we do. Because it's not just about putting on this event. You know, maybe you've heard this saying, you've been around here a lot, and maybe you haven't, but I'm going to share it with you anyways, because it was something somebody said to me my first week of being part of this church, and that is that we don't get people to get the work done, but we get the work to get the people done. And that was a weird statement when I first heard it. In fact, the person who said it to me, I said, wait, sorry, can you say that to me again? I don't think I understood that completely. And it's been something that I've experienced, but yes, and all the things I've been able to say yes to, but really predominantly with my yes in VBS, I've seen that testimony live out in my life. So I want to quickly just touch the base of why the why behind VBS, and then we'll get to all my pretty pictures over here. A few weeks back, Evan was sharing about us being part of the body of Christ, and how the body needs intersecting points, joints, to function and work. Do you remember that teaching we heard about? And as I was thinking about VBS, there's really no greater opportunity that we have in our church than this event called VBS, that we get to see that lived out, where we get to see the body lived out, where we get to see people living out who they're really meant to be. And, you know, what I want to be careful to say, and Evan kind of already said it, is that there are those of us who love to be on stage, and there are those of us who don't like to be on stage. But can you imagine if all of us in this room loved to be on stage? You know, there would be no balance. There'd be, what about the kids, and what about special events? What about all these other parts that play? But when we all get to say yes to the things that are in front of us, we get to see those things beautifully lived out. Like, a body that is all hand, a bunch of hands, is not a pretty sight. And neither is a hand by itself on the street. But a hand connected to the right body is a beautiful thing, right? Okay, so the context of that scripture in 1 Corinthians 12 is talking exactly about that. That we sometimes even bring dishonor on ourselves because we don't think we're important enough. But the Lord specifically says, in fact, can I read it to you, that scripture? 1 Corinthians chapter 12, starting verse 25, 23. It says, and those members of the body which we deem less honorable, on these we bestow abundant honor, and our less presentable members become much more presentable. So in other words, again, we appreciate our eyes, right? We appreciate the fact that we have eyes. I even appreciate the fact that I have eyebrows, because imagine what I would look like without eyebrows. But nobody ever talks about your eyebrows. Well, no guys ever talk about our eyebrows. I know you ladies talk about your eyebrows. In fact, there aren't very too many... Well, okay, I won't go down the roads. Pack it up, Michael. Turn around. But do you see that if I shaved my eyebrows, how weird I would look? You ever seen somebody shaved eyebrows? When I was a teenager, we did a challenge. And, well, I won't get into what the challenge was, but the loser had to shave their eyebrows. And one of my friends was a loser and had to shave his eyebrows. He looked like an alien. So it's in those moments that you realize my eyebrows are kind of important in life. Does that make sense? They're kind of an important part. They bring honor to my face. They make my face presentable. And without them, I am not really honorable. So in other words, we all have a part to play. And when we are playing the part that we're supposed to play, then the whole body is honored. And the Lord's purposed it that way. In fact, it says, let me just keep on reading here. It goes on to say, but God has so composed the body, giving more abundant honor to that member which lacked, so that there might be no division in the body. And that's the picture that we're drawing for you tonight, is that we all get to have a part to play. That's why we do VBS. It's a beautiful picture of how the body gets to work. Now, the theme of VBS is right over here. In the same way, this is Matthew 5:16. In the same way, let your light shine so that others might see it, that they might see the good things that you do, and they'll bring glory to your Father in heaven. Now, last year's VBS, kind of on the third or fourth day, I just had this revelation about testimonies, and that I gained testimonies in life. And it brings me confidence, and it brings me to deeper places of faith in my life. But the other thing that it does is that it's meant to be shared. It's meant to bring something to you as well. If I have a testimony of the fact that God has provided for me in some way, that's going to enrich you as well. If I have a testimony that God met me in a deep, dark, ugly place that I didn't think I had any hope in, that's going to affect your life as well when I begin to share it. That my life is meant to be shared. In fact, the whole context, I love the context of the scripture, because it says, you know, a city, you're meant to be a city set on a hill. Nobody lights a lamp and puts it under a shelf. Why do you light a lamp in a dark room? You light it so that you could see. It's meant to be useful. So when I'm living out what God has given me, when I'm living out what God's invested in me, I become useful to the world around me. And that's why they're able to see the good things that I do and give glory to God because of it, because that's not coming from me. He's the one who gave it to me to begin with. I want to teach our kids to go beyond about the things that we believe to the things that we practice because of the things that we believe. I want our church to go beyond talking about the things that we believe and put into action the things that we know to be true about God, know to be true about who we are, know to be true about what God has already done in our lives in very practical ways. This isn't mystery talk here. This is very practical talk. That's why we're going to go into five practical areas of VBS. We're going into shining in love, shining in kindness, shining in forgiveness, shining in faithfulness, shining in generosity. Are any of these words that you've never heard before? We've heard all these words. And as I say them to you, I get convicted because I feel like we've received some really good things these past few months as a church. And the best way to grow stale in the things that we're learning is to do nothing with them. The best way to keep it fresh is to give them out. So one of the things I believe to be true about the Lord is that we're all given a bag, right? That bag might be about so big, and the Lord fills up that bag. And the purpose for me having that bag and for him filling it up is to give it out. And as I'm giving out the things that are inside my bag, the Lord begins to fill that bag up again. Now, the good news is that the quicker I am at giving it out, the quicker he is at pouring it in. And when he starts to pour it in, that little bag that I had isn't going to work anymore. So what needs to happen? I need a bigger bag. So I get a bigger bag. And then as I give that stuff back out, he gets poured back in, and I need a bigger bag again. So we get to carry around these huge bags, giving it away to all who need it or want it. Does that make sense? And that is the whole point of shining it out, so that we become useful, so that we become a source to people, a light to people who live in dark places. And in this case, in VBS, sometimes that could be your neighbor who's sitting right next to you. Specifically, it could be those kids who don't go to church, who only relationship to God has been them seeing a sign out there that says, VBS summer camp, sign up starting now. And their parent needs something for them to do for the week because it's summertime and school's out, and they sign them up, and their life gets changed as a result of that. But that's what we get to do. And I want to make it really clear that isn't this a great logo, by the way? We're going to talk about that in a second, we're going to talk about it right now, actually. But I want to be really specific about this logo because you see a lighthouse on it, right? But that lighthouse is meant to remind you of who you are. This is you. That's why we created it. It wasn't an easy process. Actually, it was a pretty lengthy process to get to this point. And that brings me to another point. You know, when we had a whole nother logo all ready to go, and it was awesome. I was excited about it. And I was even sharing it with people. Look at this awesome logo. And the Lord said something differently, and it was time to do something different. It really stretched me. It was like, but we already have it done. It's done. It's printed. I've been sharing it with people. A lighthouse. Okay. Well, I just happened to be having lunch with my friend Steven. And I said, Steven, you're an artist. Can you make me a lighthouse for VBS? Sure, absolutely, he says. And so he created a lighthouse, which was this right here. Steven, that's awesome. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for doing that. It's really great. I have a few notes. That's what this represents here. Maybe we can change this. Maybe we can change that. Maybe we can go over here. You know, let me draw it out for you. I'm not an artist, but let me draw it out for you. But so here's some other things that maybe will help to inspire you. So it kind of like birthed into this beautiful thing right over here, which ultimately turned into this. My other friend, Hannah Selden, took it from here, and she decided, let me put some color to it, and it turned into this beautiful logo here. That was like, wow. But it was a process. Where we started, we had an inspiration. Where we started wasn't where we ended up. But what happened as a result of us being challenged and pushed, we got to a deeper place. We got to a more defined place. But we needed a start place. And this is really such a picture to me of this process we call VBS. And we all have a start place. And we get to go through this process that brings out these wonderful, amazing things in our lives. And so the invitation that we make to you is an invitation for this process. It's going to be challenging. It's been challenging for me. You know, if I think about it from the perspective of like, okay, 200 to 300 kids, 200 to 300 volunteers, 4 months to pull it off, I'm not sleeping well at night if I'm thinking it like that. I need to get all these directors to do all these things completely on their yes, because, you know, But when I look at it from the perspective of taking things a step at a time, because I purposed, when I said yes to this year, that I wasn't going to be stressed out by it. That if a challenge presented itself, I was either going to bust through it, climb over it, dig underneath it, or get around it, but I wasn't going to let it stop me. We're doing this. I'm doing this. We're doing this together. Because what I believe is that this process that I get to say yes to is going to bring good things to myself, to my family, and the people around me. And so the invitation I make to you, I understand what I'm saying to you. I totally get that it's going to take something from you. But I am so not afraid to ask you to do something outside of your comfort zone, because I know it's going to be good for you. I'm not afraid to challenge you outside of the places that might be scary for you, because that's where the life is over here. We think the life is where it's comfortable because we feel safe. But again, that doesn't get us anywhere. Where we want to be is out here, because that's where we get to grow. That's where we get to be defined. That's where the Lord gets to say, that's beautiful, but what if we did this? And all of a sudden, it turns from a two-dimensional picture into a three-dimensional picture with everything on it. And that's the lives we get to say yes to in the Lord. Amen? Okay. So I just quickly want to go through the aspects of these things, because this is what I'm believing. I'm believing for myself, and I'm believing for you too, that we get to learn how to live these things out a little bit more prominently in our lives. That these get to be themes that we get to say yes to, and that we get to be presented with, I'm hoping on a daily basis. Because I need a little bit more love in my life. But if I need a little bit more love in my life, I need to be giving out a little bit more love in my life. Does that make sense? So shining in love has everything to do with putting my words into action. Doing things for the sake of other people. Doing things because we love people. Not just having it be something we talk about, but looking for ways and opportunities, because sometimes those are the best times where I'm not even expecting to have to act out on anything, but then there's the opportunity and I'm going to say yes to it. Like, can I give you a small example of that? I went to the store to go buy things for kickoff weekend, and I was all excited because I'm like, I have time, I get to get these things done. I get to the checkout counter, and I totally realize I forgot my wallet. I know, right? Sorry. I forgot my wallet after he's ringing things up. Like, I'm so sorry. I totally forgot my wallet. I can't pay for this stuff. He goes, no problem. I said, okay. But when I was leaving, I'm like, ugh, how am I going to get this stuff done? You know what? It's going to happen. I don't got time. I can't. I need to keep on moving forward. I live all the way in Watsonville, so I wasn't going to drive all the way back home to get my wallet. I'm like, okay, I'll do without. I have to make do with other things that are happening right now. So not more than 5 minutes after coming to church here, my friend Jennifer Selden comes in to my office and says, hey, I'm here. Do you anything for me? But oh, Jennifer, yes. Are you headed to the store? She says, well, I'm going to the store, but I'm going to go home afterwards. So I forgot my wallet and I need some things from the store. So, oh, let me get them for you. I'll come back, totally. And I knew that her yes to me was because of our friendship. I knew that the opportunity I was presenting her, she was totally 100% willing to say yes to, because she loves me as a friend. And she wanted to do something that was going to help me in life. Those are practical things. You know, I think these are things that we all can say yes to and do, and put those things into practice. Kindness. What I love about kindness is that it's purposely thinking the betterment of somebody else to bring them along, not me along, to bring them along, to think on behalf of somebody else. Forgiveness is a big deal. I can go into a whole teaching about unforgiveness, but we are able to forgive because we've been forgiven much. We're able to let go to things that are hindering us. It's one of the lessons the kids are going to learn this the week of VBS, is that the quickest way to live in freedom is to forgive, so you don't have any hooks in your lives that are going to be pulling you back. Faithfulness. It's one of the things I loved before I started working for the Cosins full time. I was managing a store in downtown Santa Cruz, and these were one of the aspects I loved teaching the employees that I would hire at the time, was how to teach them to be faithful in the little tasks that I'm giving them. Because what they didn't know was that I was training them. What they didn't know was I was seeing how well they did in this little task I was given, so I can give them more down the road. And I wouldn't let go of it until they got it done. And I was very specific about making sure they got the job done appropriately, like I asked them to, because there was a lesson for them to be learned, not for my sake, because I wanted things to look a particular way, but for their sake, to learn what it means to be faithful with what's in front of them. And that's the picture I constantly have, is that the Lord is never trying to be mean. In fact, the scripture says, Colossians 3:23, work at everything, do it with all your heart, work like you're working for the Lord, not not on demand. Because when you work for man, you have to live under the expectations of man. Does that make sense? And when you live under the expectations of man, that's a hard thing to live under. When you have to answer to somebody, you have to answer to their rules, you have to answer their expectations. But working for the Lord means you get to be set free from that. Because one, the Lord enables you, but two, you get to gain favor with the world around you. When you finish the things that you start and you do faithfully with what is right in front of you. I'm excited to teach that to our kids. I'm excited for our church to have a season of learning and having that be one of our things, to be faithful to the things that are right in front of us, even when it gets challenging, even when it gets hard, even when I don't feel like it. But because my yes is yes, I'm going to follow it all the way through. And then shining in generosity. I love this idea of generosity, because often my perception has been in the past that you can only be generous if you have a lot to give. And that is so not the definition of generosity, is that we're generous with whatever we have. Even if in my perception, it's a little bit. But it's that same picture of that bag. Because when I'm faithful to give out what I have, I get to receive more. In fact, the scripture says, you'll be made rich in every way so that you can be generous to the people around you. That's a wonderful promise to hang on to. So the things that I get to receive are really things that are meant not just to bless my life and my family, but to bless the people around me as well. Amen? Okay. Well, let's move on then, people. We're almost to the home stretch here. Okay, VBS specifics. In the past, we've called them SWATs. Now we're calling them CHAMPs. CHAMPs. Yes, very excited about that. It's a new season of our young people being able to join our team leaders. There are opportunities straight across the board to say yes to VBS. And I want to, again, you might be feeling like I don't have much to give, but you know what? There is a place for everybody, no matter what your time is, to get involved in VBS. Even beforehand, I got plenty of opportunity for you to be involved in VBS beforehand. So don't be afraid to come and talk to me. But even if you have an hour to give, there's a place for you. There's a place for you to serve with children. Maybe you're a little bit intimidated. Maybe working with children isn't something you feel comfortable with. You know what? We have other places in VBS for you to serve in, whether that's with the food or with traffic. If you don't feel comfortable with doing crafts or art, you can sell snacks or work in special events. Or maybe you're somebody who loves to do sports. We have a whole sports thing going on in the mornings of VBS. There are places to say yes to straight across the board. The field is wide open. The other part that's really fun about this is that when we all get to say yes to these things, our wonderful volunteer directing team starts putting these little teams together. You get to work with people you wouldn't normally get to spend that amount of time with. That's the true beauty of saying yes to VBS, is that you get connected to people in a way that you would never be able to get connected to them before. That's really my testimony. When I very first said yes to VBS, I was brand new to the church. I really didn't know anybody very well. But by the end of that season, I felt like I'd been around here for 10 years already because of those bonds that you create and the time that you get to spend with people. VBS dates are June 20th through the 24th. You have plenty of time to think that through, but it's going to happen really fast. Kids registration begins in mid-April. So this kickoff weekend is for you to start preparing the way for those kids signups that are going to happen in about a month's time. After this service is over, if you haven't seen it already, there's a big booth in the foyer over here. It kind of snowballed into a big booth. Well, the truth is that I was planning to be out in the courtyard because, you know, we have we have our meals after service out in the courtyard. And that's kind of a lively place. Everybody hangs out there. But then I thought, well, it's going to be rain, so bring it in temporarily. But then it hit me that, well, we're moving to church on Sunday mornings, two services with not an evening meal. We better you better just stay in the foyer then the whole time. So we got to put up a permanent home. But I bought these really cool lights that I wanted to use. And how do you hang lights from like those 20-foot ceilings? And I had this great idea, and poor Chris Jellison. Chris, I have this idea. What if we built an awning? No. Yes. That was his response. And then it's kind of, and here we are, we got a booth now with an awning and lights. Yeah. So come and see us after church. Come and talk to us. You know what we want to do? We want to pray with you too. Maybe you don't know. Maybe you're being challenged. Maybe you just don't know what the best fit is for you. That's really okay. We want to pray with you. Okay? So come and check us out at the booth. If you want a t-shirt, these t-shirts are on sale today. We have this beautiful gray shirt. It's $16. We're taking pre-orders for this really cool, I know you've been admiring my hoodie. I know you have, because it has these cool things on it. You're like, where do I get one of those? I've never seen that before. Well, you can pre-order these at the VBS booth. We also have hats coming. They're not printed yet, but they're coming. And we also have a special edition blue shirt. I'm looking for somebody who has one on here today, tonight. Oh, Jennifer's over here. There you go. Kevin has one on. They're cool, aren't they? And you know you want to buy one. So they're also in a VBS booth. Now, I didn't tell you about the VBS colors, huh? VBS colors this year are, can you guess them? Can you, just by looking at the logo, can you guess them? The red, the blue, the yellow gold, and the light blue. That's why these are printed out. These are the Pantone colors for spring, summer, 2016. So we're going for this color, this color, this color, and that color. One of the reasons why we have shirts and colors and all these things is that they're pointing us into the direction of all the things that we're sharing tonight. You know, when John the Baptist came, he said, prepare the way for the Lord, you know, make way, make room for the Lord. These are our statements of doing just that. You know, in themselves, they're t-shirts and they're colors and it's a pretty design, but what they get to represent and what we get to give the meaning to are all the things that we've been talking about, are those statements of faith, are those challenges, and the promises of what God is going to do. That as we shine our lights to this dark world around us, people get to see that, and they'll praise our Father who lives in heaven because of the things that we're doing. And as a result, we get to be blessed, that our bags get to be full, that God, that we get to live in this life that is rich and rewarding and meaningful and worth something. And I love this statement that we get to participate in things that are bigger than ourselves, bigger than what we can imagine or dream of on our own, that we get to be connected to something that is going to take us to deeper places in the Lord. Again, I'm giving you both an invitation to join us in VBS this year and a challenge. And it's not like I challenge you kind of a challenge. It is a challenge that would hopefully bust you out of a comfortable place of living into something that's much greater. I want to challenge you to step out in faith, to believe that God has something for you that is new, fresh, and different. Amen? Okay. You going to pray? Am I going to pray? Evan's going to pray.
Stay here.
I'm going to stay up here.
Michael, can you give us maybe a quick list of some of the practical areas for people to get involved in? Like, what are the things that they can be considering to join and volunteer for?
Yes. Well, to be a team leader is a pretty amazing thing. So team leading is you get a group of kids, you're with them all week long, you get to experience life with them, you get to be part of their special events. I recently got a refreshment as to why we do special events. It's an activity in the afternoon that we get to participate in with the kids. We always do these big, out-of-control games and things like that. We actually need lots of people to pull those games and things off. But one of the elements of why we get to go so big isn't for the sake of going big. That was a little bit of a revelation that we just don't do special events because it's special events. We do special events because it breaks down walls in the kids. And if we can begin to foster a relationship between them and their team leaders that goes beyond just their normal lives, then we're going to get someplace with them. So being part of special events, being part of, we have sports and games in the morning. We have art areas that if you love doing artwork. I said it earlier, selling snacks. We have a whole kitchen crew if you like working with food and like to be around some fun adults. Parking teams, traffic, kids loading and unloading, being part of the assembly team. My goodness, if you love to be on stage, we have our all call, which is an all call to our church. If you're interested in being on stage or being part of the production of that, maybe behind the scenes, we have our all call happening tomorrow right here between 1 and 4 o'clock. Come and be part of that with us. You can learn to work sound. You can learn to work stage. All kinds of great areas.
Great. Okay. Thank you. So if you didn't catch it, there's a lot. And if you still have a question in your heart and your mind about where could I jump in, come by the booth. Come by the awning with lights on it and ask them, how can I get involved? What are the sorts of things that you can get involved in? And that's very much in line with what I'm feeling from the Lord, that he's saying ask. So he's asking you to ask. So come and ask. All right? Would you bow your heads with me, though, and close your eyes as we wrap up our service tonight? Lord, I thank you for the tremendous opportunity that we get to partner with you in such big things. And just the disparity between our ability, our power, and the big things that you invite us to be a part of is overwhelming sometimes. To think about your bigness, to think about your greatness, to think about eternity, and that things that we can do now, small things, to contribute towards those big things, those eternal things. What a tremendous invitation, Lord. And as you sit on your throne and your authority and your power, still you see each and every person here, and you know who they are, and you have things for each and every one of them. So Lord, I pray that right now you'd speak to them, you would tug on their heart, you would whisper something to them of a passion, of something you're asking them to do, to contribute towards. But like Michael said, not just something that they can do, but rather something that would be done in them. Lord, I pray that our church would be a changed church after this VBS. And I pray for the kids, Lord, that would come. May many come to know you. May many come into your kingdom, Lord. Thank you, God, for this opportunity we have. We pray in your name, Jesus. Amen. Amen. Well, speaking of kids, please go run and get them. We went a little bit late tonight, so go get your kids. Hang out. Go to the VBS booth. Thank you for being here this evening. We'll see you next week.